What are you up to now?
What in Merlin's name were you doing in the restricted section? What did you think you'd find there? Answers to your exams? If I discover even a trace of dark magic,
you'll never believe what I've learned.
What did you discover in the spellbook we found in the scriptorium?
Salazar Slytherin's spellbook was a little difficult to interpret, but fascinating. Evidently, he encouraged teaching dark magic at Hogwarts. Neither the Imperious Curse nor the Killing Curse was unforgivable during his time. He believed students should be prepared to use dark magic when necessary, not to fear it. That's why we had to use Crucio to gain access to the scriptorium. He didn't want his knowledge shared with anyone who was afraid of the power of dark magic.
It was hard to do, but casting Crucio was our only option.
And I'm glad we did it, because in the spellbook I also found something else. References to a lost relic, which, from what I can tell, grants the holder the power to reverse dark magic curses.
And you think this relic might be able to save Anne?
Precisely. I plan to search for this relic, but I don't think we should tell anyone. Especially Ominous. He wouldn't understand.
I see no reason to involve Ominous.
I'm glad you agree. When I know more, I shall send an owl. And don't feel sorry for Ominous. Keeping this to ourselves for now is for his own good.
I'll decide what's for my own good.
Ominous, we were just about to get some air. Care to join?
You're a liar, Sebastian. I heard everything. You swore you'd never engage in anything to do with dark magic again.
No, I didn't. I said I understood you wanting that. I'd never swear to give up on finding a cure for Anne.
You don't know when to stop, do you?
I know when not to stop. Leave this alone, Ominous. I'll be on my way.
I am not letting this go.
Ominous, Sebastian meant well.
I know what I heard. You knew I wouldn't agree with this. Going after that relic is not a good idea. Sebastian doesn't even realize it, but he's as irresponsible and reckless now as his parents were years ago. It's why they died.
I knew his parents died, but I never heard what happened.
Mr. and Mrs. Sallow were professors. Spent nearly every waking moment in the cellar library. Noses buried in books. Anne and Sebastian were upstairs when it happened. They heard a sudden crash and ran downstairs, but it was too late. Their parents had crumpled to the floor. A defect with the lamp in the cellar caused the room to fill with an undetectable toxin. Sebastian and Anne were helpless. They had no magic yet.
What a horrible story.
It is. That's why I can't understand Sebastian's recklessness. I've practically lost Anne. I cannot lose Sebastian too. Please avoid anything to do with that spellbook.
Those references in the book seem promising.
Everything to do with Salazar Slytherin seems promising until it's too late. I hope Sebastian pursues this no further, but if you think he might, please let me know. It would mean a lot.
Repair all.
Off on another adventure, are we?
High Wing, go!
Prove dangerous if I'm not careful.
Revelio. Levioso. Revelio. Levioso.
Assignment's all finished.
Levioso. Accio.
Excellent work today. Class dismissed. I take it you're ready to learn your new...
I completed your assignment, Professor. I'm ready to learn Bombarda now.
Good. Now, this spell comes with a caveat. It should only be used when necessary. The exploding charm, as you might suspect, can hurt people. Use caution when casting it.
I will, Professor.
I will hold you to that promise. Now, you must be precise in your wand movements. We don't want you blowing your hand off. Go ahead. Nice and steady wand movements. Remember, the exploding charm is highly volatile. Well done. Now, let us put it into practice, shall we? Go ahead and try it on the pumpkins.
Bombarda!
Excellent wand work. Cast the spell just like that every time. Assured and in control.
Bombarda!
Excellent. You have it well in hand.
Confringo! Bombarda! Bombarda! Confringo! Bombarda! Expelliarmus! Bombarda! Expelliarmus! Capulso! Descendo! Confringo! Capulso! Expelliarmus! Lumos! Accio! Levioso! Thank you.
moment.
Deke has an idea to share with you.
Hello, Deke. You wanted to talk to me.
Indeed. Deke thought you might want to learn how to build a breeding pen so that you can breed beasts.
That sounds like a very good idea.
Rescuing and breeding beasts go hand in hand. Young beasts are particularly vulnerable to poachers. Breeding beasts here in the room will allow us to keep the younger ones safe.
I see. What do I need to do?
First, bring a pair of beasts to the room. One male, one female. Deke suggests rescuing thestrals, as they're at great risk from poachers. Noble creatures, but their relationship with death gives them a bad reputation. They're prized by poachers for their tail hairs.
I've seen thestrals before, but where would I find a pair of them nearby?
Deke has seen some wild thestrals not too far from the Hogwarts grounds. Then you'll need to purchase a spellcraft for the pen from Tomes and Scrolls and gather the materials it requires. Once you've rescued the thestrals and you have the spellcraft, you come and find Deke.
Does it get any more cozy than Hogsmeade?
Just let me know if
Revelio. What do we have here? Demiguys.
Let's look at what we have, shall we?
Now I can conjure a breeding pen in the room. Best get back to Deke with the thestrals.
Nothing like finding just the right thing, is there? Let me know if there's anything else I can do to help.
I've rescued the Thestrals and bought the spellcraft for the pen.
Excellent! Now, to breed your Thestrals, simply release them into the same vivarium in which you conjure the pen. Then use the pen to start the process. Come and see Deke when you're finished.
I shall. I wonder where I should conjure their pen.
Never grows tired of the room's surprises. We now have the perfect place for those Thestrals. Please let Deke know once you've bred them.
Thank you. Thank you.
Nice to see you, my young friend.
Revelio. Revelio.